Hello, and welcome to the Mentor's Tale webinar. I'm Sotiris Karagiannis. I'm the Graduate Programs Director of the University of New York in Prague and a dedicated mentor for the last 28 years. I'm a senior practitioner accredited by EMCC, and I'm here to share with you my vision about how storytelling, how tales can help mentors inspire and engage their people in the mentor-mentee coaching relationship. In all my career, I have been looking for ways to help people engage in change, embrace positive change, feel confident that their lives can be better, more productive, more fulfilling, happier. And I have found that using stories, our stories are as mentors, stories that are written and told for years, can help our mentees feel better with what they want to do, dig in the stories, find themselves as the heroes of the stories, and eventually be more inspired than any other method that we know so far. So join me in a bit in this webinar for more. Stay tuned. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. My name is Sotiris Karagiannis. I am originally from Athens, Greece, where I'm here now for the holidays. And I permanently live in the Czech Republic, in Prague, where I manage the graduate programs of the University of New York in Prague. And I also run my mentoring as an accredited mentor of EMCC. I'm really happy to have you all here.
Okay, 大家好，我叫 Sotirios。我现在是在希腊雅典，然后我现在正在度假当中。那我现在是纽约大学布拉格分校硕士学位项目主任，同时呢，也是一位 EMCC 认证的高级导师。很高兴见到大家。Okay.
In my career for almost 28, 30 years as a mentor, I have been trying to find ways to improve the mentoring experience and engage and inspire mentees so they see a real purpose behind the mentoring relationship. And searching, I have found the art of storytelling, or if you like, the magic of storytelling, as one of the most influential tools we can use as mentors. That's what I would like to present to you today. Okay.
Okay. 那么我有28到30年的导师辅导经验。那么在我过去的职业生涯当中呢，我也一直在寻找各种方法来提升导师辅导效果。那么我同时还致力于就吸引还有帮助我们的学员，然后以此让他们在导师辅导关系当中受到更大的启发。那么同时我也发现就是讲故事这个方法是有着很大的魔力，它是一个非常有影响力的导师辅导技能。
Maybe we can start with a story. Perhaps you know or you don't know that the word mentor came from the ancient Greek mythology, and it was the goddess Athena from the Olympian gods, who was visiting Telemachus, the son of Ulysses, when Ulysses was fighting in Troy. And Athena appeared in front of Telemachus as a mentor, which meant she played the mother, in other words, the figure that would protect Telemachus, and the father, since Ulysses was away, to teach Telemachus how to fight and protect the kingdom of Ithaca. So in reality, mentor provides this kind of support, help, guidance, until the mentee feels free to let go and stand on their own feet.
Okay, 那么这个首先呢，我开始先给大家讲一个故事。这个故事呢，就是关于这个导师的起源。因为导师的起源，它是源自古希，是源自古希腊的一种方法。那么当时这里呢，就要涉及到我们的雅典娜女神。
So what I would like to, sorry.
但是当时他的国是国王，当时是。就是在那个我们的荷马史诗当中的一个人物，然后当时他们的国王就是希望他的儿子能够在特洛伊战争中就取得胜利，然后当时就帮他找了一位导师，这位导师呢就叫 mentor，也就是我们现在的 mentor，也就是导师，以前的意思也叫门徒，然后是以此帮他儿子在战争中取得胜利。OK。
Okay, what I would like to cover with you today is, first of all, I would like to make a case from the neuroscience perspective why stories are a very powerful tool to inspire our mentees. Then I would like to talk about the content of the stories, how we can use them in the mentee mentor relationship, and then use some examples of stories. I will share a personal story that I use in my mentoring relationships to show the impact. And at the end, I will be happy to discuss any questions you have regarding this art we're incorporating in our mentoring role. Okay.
Okay. 那么今天我们的那个主要是我们的问题主要有三个部分。那么首先第一个部分呢，我会从神经科学的角度来讲述为什么讲故事是非常有力的一个导师辅导工具，它是如何帮助我们的学员受到启发的。然后第二部分呢，是我会具体讲述就是故事的内容，然后。以及如何在我们的导师辅导过程当中使用这个讲故事这个技能。那第三部分呢，我会跟讲一些例子，可能从比如说分享一些我自己的导师辅导故事，然后来说明这个讲故事它是如何就是产生效果的。那最后呢，我会就是回答大家的问题，然后我们来一起讨论。
Now, starting with evidence from neuroscience, what we have found is that stories are 25 times more powerful in inspiring people than any other method of communication we can try in our relationship with our mentees. There was some time many years ago that a neurosurgeon was carrying out an experiment with a patient who had damaged the right hemisphere of his brain after an accident. And the scientist found that this person had difficulty making decisions of any kind. That was the first time that we could see that the role of emotions that stories actually wake up in us is perhaps the most important way to communicate and influence our mentees. Okay?
Okay, 那么首先呢，就是在有神经科学证据表明，就讲故事这个方法呢，它会比就我们在导师辅导过程当中所用的其他所有的沟通方式更有效，而这个有效呢，这个数据大概是25倍，达到比他们有25倍多的更有效、更有力。那么以前有神经，我们的神经专家他曾经做过一个实验，就是有一个人他出了车祸，然后脑损伤呢，这个时候影响的就是他大脑的右半球，然后发现这个脑损伤以后呢，他无法去做决定。这也是第一次我们发现，就是通过。就是一个人的我们的情感它会 非常就是对我们的沟通方式会造成很大的影响。那么我们在导师辅导过程当中呢，也就是可以参考，就是从这个情感的角度来去激发学员。
Actually, more than 70% of the information we process in our brains is processed through our emotions. We retain a lot more information by using the emotional part of our brain than reason. And this is more evidence. Sorry. Okay. Shall I start again?
I want you to speak short sentences, and I will so that I
Okay.
can better follow you.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
No problem.
Yeah.
So again, I was saying that more than 70% of the information we process in our brains is processed through emotions. The rest is through reason. Okay.
Yeah，那有就是研究表明呢，就是我们就在我们的处理的信息当中，有超过70%的信息，就是我们大脑中处理的信息，就我们大脑处理的信息当中，有超过70%的信息是我们通过情绪而不是理性来处理的。Yeah。
And when we want to inspire people as leaders or mentors, appealing to their emotions, in other words, using stories, is the most effective way to have an impact on them than any other means of communication. Okay?
对，就当我们作为一位领导者或者导师去激励学员的时候，那么就是要讲故事是比其他任何的沟通方式更有效的方式，因为可以通过讲故事来那个触及他们的情绪点，这个讲故事方法是最有效的。
And perhaps the most important thing about stories, if you think about the times that we were listening to the stories or the tales from our grandfathers and grandmothers, the most important thing that keeps our attention focused is because we are always there to hear the ending of the story.
那么，也许比如说我们生活当中的例子，就是我们会听我们，就是我们的父母啊，或者祖父母，他们会给我们讲故事。而在听故事过程当中，最重要的呢，就是我们会非常的在意自己的一个意图、一个想法。这个意图是什么呢？就是我们特别期待听到这个故事的结尾。
Imagine that even the best PowerPoint presentation you have ever used in your lives is not as strong as the story. The story actually is 25% times stronger than any other means of communication, even the best PowerPoint we've ever used in our careers.
Okay. 那么再举个例子，就是即使我们用过的 PPT，哪怕是你就是人生到现在用过的最好的 PPT，它的沟通效果也不如讲故事，因为讲故事它的那个沟通效果要比其他任何的沟通方法要强25%的倍数。
So let's go and see what the story is about. What do we mean by a story in mentoring and how it is constructed? A story
OK，
has a hero.
让我们接下来，让我们看了来看一下这个故事，了解一下这个故事的构成。OK。
A story has a hero. The hero is the mentor. The hero can be the mentee or any other person from a story the mentor would like to use.
那么。
The story has a plot, a struggle, a conflict, and an ending. Okay.
那么首先这个故事呢，首先它有一个主角，那这个主角呢，它可以是导师，也可以是学员，也可以是任何其他这个导师使用，导师在他在那个导师在辅导过程当中，他用到的那个人，然后呢，就是涉及到情节，然后情节包括可能这个人可能遭遇了什么样的痛苦，对。
If the story is about you as the mentor, so you are the hero in the story, your mentee would like to know what conflicts, what struggles, what problems you were facing in your careers. And this is the part of the story. This is what will attract their attention to talk about your success. We're going to talk mainly about this and how you dealt with them.
那么，然后比如说你这个主角是你导师讲故事，然后这个时候学员他更多期待听到的是冲突，然后你遇到的困难，这是故事的主要部分。就学员他可能不会期待你讲你成关你遇到的失败，以及你如何从失败中走出来的。
In this way, your mentees level with you. They understand that you're also as human as they are, that you have made mistakes in your life, that you learn from them, and these mistakes actually helped you become what builds relationship of trust.
那么从这个角度呢，就是可以让你的学员他去更加的理解你，因为大家都是，因为都是人类，人类呢，大家就是都会可能有相似的遭遇，然后通过这种方式呢，可以让学员就是更好的就是理解，然后并且也可以在导师和学员之间那个建立一个良好的信任关系。
Then the last part of your story is about how you manage to deal with your problems, with your difficulties, give your story a happy ending, and the most important thing at the end is the message. What did you learn? Why is the story important for you? Why do you want to share the story with your mentees?
那么最后一部分呢，就是说，就是关于这个主人公他是如何解决这个问题，解决他的困难的，就是说我们得到了一个 happy ending 快乐的结局。那在这个整个过程当中呢，一个比较重要的一点是关于信息传递的信息，就是你从这个故事当中你学到了什么，那这个故事它为什么重要，以及导师他为什么要分享这个故事。
One of the other very important things about your stories is that they have to be relevant to your relationship with your mentee. Don't just choose any story that is not really what your mentee would like to hear about you. Talk about those stories that really make sense and align with the relationship between you and your mentee. That's the way for your mentee to travel through your story to a happy ending.
那么还有一个最重要的、非常重要的一点就是，你讲的故事要与你们，要与你导师和学员之间的关系要相关。你不是讲那些就是学员可能自己想听的故事，你要自己想就是如何就是与你们的之间的关系更相关、更合理的故事，让这个故事更加的相关合理。
Now, the next question obviously is, are you going to be using only your own stories? Are you going to invite your mentee to also tell their own stories? Are you going to use stories from a deposit of stories that are available from what we know from our own experience with stories from books. So let's talk a little bit about that for now.
然后下面呢，就是说我们要就是讲故事。那么导师呢，可以讲述自己的故事，也可以让学员去讲自己的故事。那这个讲故事呢，主要的目的其实是我们希望是探讨，就是说从这个故事当中，我们去发现更积极的一面。这个故事它其实也可以从书本中得来，也可以是从我们现实生活中来那个。也可以来自于现实生活中，yeah。
Okay, the first thing, of course, is to use your own stories, as we were saying before. And in a bit, I'm going to share one of my stories that have marked my life. The next thing is to consider stories from your mentees, but we have to be a little bit careful about that. We're going to talk about that in a bit, okay?
对，第一步呢是。就是导师首先是分享自己的故事，那然后呢，就是让学员再分享自己的故事。
So if I am to share with you a story that has marked my life, and I will say that in bits so you can see the impact. In 1990, master's in States in Boston. Okay.
OK，那我就现在就让我来分享我自己的故事。我大概在1990年的时候，当时在波士顿，然后完成了自己的硕士学习。
And I had a professor in the university who was also my mentor and who decided one day to make a party and invite some of his old students from the city, from Boston.
那我有一位教授，这位教授同时也是我的导师。那我的导师他有一天他要举办一个聚会，然后邀请那个在波士顿的他以前的学生一起过来参加聚会。
One of the students who was invited was a young man who was involved in a car accident, had injured his spine, and as a result, remained on the wheelchair for the rest of his life.
那其中有一个学生呢，是他非常年轻，但是他出了一场车祸，这场车祸导致他脊柱受伤，然后要终身坐在轮椅上。
There were chances for him to recover, but he was not feeling well. His psychology was really bad, so there was no single opportunity for him to ever, recover and leave the wheelchair.
那其实他本来是有机会可以恢复的，但他当时的心理状况实在是太糟糕了，导致他失去了这个康复的机会，也没有办法再离开轮椅。
The day came, the party started. I was there helping my mentor, and the students started coming. And at some point, the young man came on his wheelchair.
然后呢，宴会开始了，然后这个年轻人他坐着轮椅也过来了。
And when they met and hugged each other after 2 or 3 years that they hadn't seen each other, the young man turns to his professor and says,
然后他们有大概有12年没有见面了。然后见面的时候呢，他们相互拥抱，然后这位年轻人，然后就是面向这位导师，然后说："
And he says, Prof, I didn't bring you a present today because my present is different. And when he says that, he stands up and starts walking.
”然后他说。教授， 我今天没有带礼物过来，但是我有一个非常特别的礼物。然后他说的这个话的时候呢，然后从轮椅上站了起来，并且开始走路。
And Tenzin says, thanks to you. Thanks for all these years that you were next to me and you believed in me. I managed to get my strengths back. And with the help of my doctors, here I am walking again.
教授，谢谢你，谢谢你这么多年一直陪在我身边，谢谢你这么相信我，才让我有力量重新站起来，就让我活过来。那现在我在这里，我能走路了。
Thank you for giving me my life back. This was his last words after he stood up.
谢谢你，因为你我才能回到我过去的样子。这是他最后的话。
This story that happened to me in 1990 is one I will never forget because it has taught me a great lesson about what we can do to people when we truly believe in them.
那这个故事呢，发生在1990年，我终身不能忘怀，因为这个故事它给了我很大的启发，就是让我想我能为别人做什么，然后去相信他们，然后影响到他们。
Every time I use this story with my mentees, I did what should you do to inspire your people, your team, how leader that will get the trust.
那我每次在面对我的学员的时候呢，我都会讲这个故事，因为这个故事呢，最后就回归到一个问题上面，就是你能做什么去鼓舞你身边的人，去激励你的员工？你如何成为才能成为一位真诚、一位真实的领导者，然后以此呢来赢得你下属的信任？
And in my mentoring relationship with them, I invite them to think how they can use the lesson I learned back in 1990 with some of their people so that they can give them the strength to be able to stand on their own feet, improve their performance, improve their engagement and motivation.
Yeah. 去思考，就如何利用我的这段经历，然后如何运用到他们的生活当中，然后去就给予别人力量，然后让别人靠自己站起来，然后并且呢，提升我们在比如说工作中的表现，然后激励他人，然后并增强他们的参与度。
I'm sure all of us have stories we can share with our mentees, stories like the one I shared with you today, which will point to the emotional part of our mentees. And as I was telling you before, this is where they will pay more attention to you. This is where they will think about you as a person they really want to be like.
那么，我想我们自己都有故事可以分享给我们的学员。那就像我今天分享的这个故事，它主要是它可以从情感上然后触动别人，然后以此呢就是让他们也是让学员就是更加注意到就是如何能够在生活中就是 勇敢的面对生活，并激励别人。
Even if you don't want to use your own stories, you can always think of stories that are relevant, as I was saying before, and which also are a source of inspiration for you.
那如果你就是不想用自己的故事的话，你可以去想想有哪些相关的故事，那这些故事呢，也能鼓舞启发别人。
There's a great story. The editor-in-chief of this non-profit organization that publishes street magazines and gives them to homeless people to sell them in the streets and make a decent living.
那我还有一个非常棒的故事，这是一位就是主编讲述的，就是有一个非政府组织，那这个组织呢，他们会制作街头杂志，然后把这些杂志给到那些无家可归的人，让那些无家可归的人拿去卖，然后以此赚一些钱来维生。
One day, the editor-in-chief was asked by a journalist about his vision for his company. And the person said, "My dream is that one day my company will no longer exist."
那么有一天，有一位记者就问了这个主编一个问题，他的公司的愿景是什么？然后这个主编回答说："我希望有一天我的公司不再存在。"
This is an emotionally appealing story because this person simply says that if my company no longer exists, it means that I have accomplished my mission and I have helped all these homeless people to find a home to stay and live for the rest of their lives.
那这个故事呢，其实是一个非常令人感动的故事。就这位主编说，如果我的公司不再存在了，那我就完成了我的使命。我是想帮助那些无家可归的人，让他们有居所可以住，然后可以下班，可以在他们的余下来的那个生命当中，可以有一个地方可以安身。
Well, if I refer to the Chinese philosophy, it's so full of great stories that you can use from all these fantastic philosophers for the thousands of years that China has been in this world. And I'm sure there's a rich deposit of stories that you can use and relate with your mentees.
那我想，就是我们中国，因为中国几千年的文化里有很多伟大的思想家、哲人，他们曾经也讲述过很多故事。那我非常非常确信，就是你们也有很多积极的故事可以去讲述，可以向学员讲述。
So, if we go to think about where we can use stories in mentoring, I would like to go through some of the basic opportunities we're having and give you some examples.
那接下来呢，就是关于就是如我们是在导师辅导过程当中，是在什么样的情况下可以用这个故事？接下来我们就来了解这方面。
One of the things we do as mentors is to help our mentees set goals and envision the future.
那作为导师呢，我们面对学员的时候，其中就是要做的，就是要帮助他们去 设定目标并展望未来。
We can use traditional approaches like a miracle question, help them visualize, but using a story. And in this case, asking our mentees to tell their own story about the future has a great impact.
在这个当中呢，我们可以使用一些方法，比如说包括一些可能比较一些可能比如说神话式的提问，一些神话式的问题，然后就是说在他们的脑海中去形成一幅画面，然后去问我们的学员，包括就是他们未来对未来有什么想法。
Invite your mentees to tell their own story about their future. Give them the structure, a hero, a struggle, solution, and the morale, the ending, and ask them to paint, craft their own story about how they see themselves 3 or 5 years from now.
那我们就是让学员呢自己去讲编造一个关于未来的故事，那可以给他设定一个故事的框架，这个框架里面呢包括有主角，然后这个主角可能面临的困难，然后是他解决困难的方法，那最后呢就是得到什么结论，那就让我们的学员去讲述去编造，就是编一个故事，然后这个故事呢就是说他们可能比如说在经历过3到5年以后，他们会就是是什么样子，是如何看待自己的。
Ask them about telling a story how they see themselves in the future, how they would like others to see them also, what difficulties, what hurdles, barriers may stand in their way, and what the final result will be after they get over their problems.
那让他们去讲述他们在未来他们是如何看待自己的，以及别人又是怎么看待他们的，他们遇到了什么困难，遇到了什么障碍，然后最后呢又是如何解决困难的。
And when they tell the story, ask them not only to tell you what they're going to do, but also what they must not do in order to reach the desired end in their goals.
那不只要让他们讲他们就是未来会做的事，也一定要让他们讲述他们一定不会做的事，然后以此达到他们预期的结果，然后实现预期的目标。
There's a great book you probably know by Marshall Goldsmith. The title of the book is What Got You Here Won't Get You There.
那有一本书可能很出名的，大家可能都知道，就是 What Got You Here What Got You There。
And Marshall Goldsmith is telling people exactly this, what to stop doing to go to the next level of success.
那他这个故事呢，他告诉人们就是要取得未来取得成功的，那么首先要做些什么。
So let's go now to the next topic of storytelling in mentoring, which is about problem solving.
那接下来让我们探讨下一个话题，就是关于解决问题。
What is one of the main difficulties for our mentees when they have to solve problems? They are looking at things sometimes from a pessimistic outlook.
这个呢，主要就是涉及到，就是学员他在解决问题的时候，他有时候可能会 采取一种非常悲观的态度。
A story where you talked about your own problems, how you went through them, how you managed to get rid of all the issues and the obstacles could be one to help them also start thinking of solving their own problems with optimism.
就我们通过故事来讲述自己的问题，以及包括你遭遇了什么，然后又是如何去摆脱这些难题障碍，可以就是有助于我们这些学员，就是从悲观转到积极乐观的角度来看待问题。
I like often to talk about my own story. And I like my mentees to think of me as the person who almost 30 years before I was confronted with a serious financial problem because my family went bankrupt.
那我经常非常喜欢跟学员分享我自己的故事。那这一页呢，就是讲述了我大概在30年前就遭遇的一些困境。然后我当时，比如说家庭经济崩溃。
I had lost everything. I was not feeling very, good about my future. One day I met one of my old teachers, and that was a moment of enlightenment and inspiration for me.
Okay, 当时呢，我失去了一切，然后对未来就是毫无信心，就丧失了一切斗志。然后直到有一天，我遇到了以前的老师，他给了我非常大的鼓舞。
That was the time that this teacher helped me think of myself in the past when many of my classmates were coming to me for help and advice.
就我的老师呢，他让我回想到过去，当时我的同学他们经常来找我帮忙，而我经常也愿意帮助他们。
He helped me find my true north, my purpose in life, and I ended up being a mentor. It was in that moment in my life that there was somebody next to me who showed me the way.
那他帮我找到了我人生的方向，然后确定了我人生的目标，就是成为一位导师。那有这样一位可以去，就像这位导师一样，他可以一直陪着我，可以帮助我。
And since then, I have been sharing my personal story with my mentees when I want to help them understand that when they have to solve a problem, they're not on their own. They can always seek the help of other people next to them.
那这个故事呢，就是我们可以跟学员分享，就是帮助学员去知道，他们不是只有自己。他们也可以去依赖身边的人，向他们寻求帮助。
One of the most important things in a mentee's life is to understand at some point that they have weaknesses and that they have to seek help. That's our role as mentors, one way or the other.
那就是对于学员呢，对于他们而言，在生活当中非常重要的一件事呢，就是他们要有自我的意识，他们可以去思考，也可以去帮助别人。
So by telling them our own story, how someone we found in our lives made a difference and helped us our serious problems.Is one thing that the mentee should also be looking for until they're able to stand on their own feet, fully independent.
那跟学员分享我们自己的故事呢？ 因为这些故事呢，其实让很多人就是在生活中发生了非常积极的改变，就如何去解决非常重大的问题。那跟学员分享这些故事呢，可以帮助他们就是发现自己的问题，然后能够重新树立信心并站起来。
Next topic, reframing and creativity.
那下一个话题呢，我们来讲重构和创造力。
Why we need this in the mentoring relationship? Because we want our mentees to start thinking out of the box.
那在导师辅导关系当中呢，我们会非常希望学员去换种角度思考问题，而不是陷入。 以前的曾经的思维窠臼。
In this case, I like giving them a prompt from George Bernard Shaw.
那从这里 呢，我想给一个关于是肖伯纳的一些话。
Who once said, "You see things as they are and ask why."
然后就是你看到就是一些事物，看见这些事物的样子，你会问为什么？
I dream of things as they could have been and ask why not.
那这个时候呢，我其实可以问，为什么不可以这样呢？
When I give them this prompt from Bernard Shaw, some people say probably it was Pablo Picasso who said this thing, but it doesn't matter. I then ask them to tell me a story where they found themselves thinking like Bernard Shaw or Picasso.
那然后我呢会让他们就说告诉我一个讲，给我讲一个故事，比如说他们从肖伯纳或者毕卡索的角度想问题，这样相关的一个故事。
And their mind unfolds. They can think of themselves in situations where they were really out of the box, where they were creative and innovative, where they took risks and were not afraid of failing.
那这个时候呢，就是思绪，你思绪就打开了，你会自己设想一些情境，然后这些情境呢，它是充满了创意，还有创造力。在这些情境当中呢，你非常的敢于冒险，并且不怕失败。
And let's move now to the next one, empowerment.
OK，来，那我们再看下一个 topic，一个话题就是赋能 empowerment。
Why do we want our mentees to feel empowered? Because we live in a world which is full of anxiety, ambiguity, and turbulence.
那我为什么希望就是我们的学员他们就是感到非充满能量呢？ 因为我们身处在一个充满焦虑，然后充满混乱，然后可能是也充满很多模糊的一个现实世界里。
And empowerment again here is about our stories, is about how we felt when we were in front of problems and how we made it to a successful end.
那这个问题呢，它可能又涉及到我们，就是面临了哪些问题，然后最后我们又是如何解决问题。
There's a great film with Al Pacino, which is called Scent of a Woman. And at some point, Al Pacino says, I have been through many crossroads in my life. Okay.
那有一部电影是关于 Al Pacino 的电影，他说就是在我的人生当中，我遇到过很多交叉口，遇到了很多困难。And
I always knew which road to take, but I never did because it was too damn hard.
Could you repeat that?
Yes, and then he said, and I always knew which route to take, but I never did because it was too hard.
其实通常呢，我其实知道我应该走哪条路，但是我不敢去走，因为我觉得这个很难。Using
this part of the story from the movie Scent of a Woman, I try to ignite in my students a passion for success. I try to make them put themselves in the hero of Al Pacino and find solutions without fear.
那我会对我的学员去讲这个故事，然后以此激发他们对 成功的热情，让他们勇于去追求成功，就让他们自己去成为故事中的主角，然后去寻找答案，无所畏惧地寻找答案。
And here's the last part. Success and self-esteem. How can we help our mentees with one of the most important things in their life to feel successful and have a high self-esteem?
那最后一点呢，也是就是对我们学员的，就是人生当中非常重要的话题，就是关于自尊和成功。Here
is where I invite my students to use a little bit of positive psychology and think about their character strengths.
那在这个话题上面呢，就是我去 让我的学生，然后是通过用积极心理学的角度来去分析角色。I
asked them to do the online survey, which is called VIA, Character Strengths Survey.
那我让他们去做一个关于 VIA 的一个在线调查。And
once they find their character strengths, I ask them to tell me stories where they can see their strengths being applied in full and them being at the top level of performance.
那我会去让他们发现这个就是主人公的优点在哪里。 然后通过讲故事的方法呢，就是充分运用这个优点，然后呢来提升你的表现。Let
me give you an example. Suppose you are the mentor and your mentees are people in sales.
那我举一个例子，就你呢是导师，然后你的学员呢，他是一位销售人员。
What is one of the most important challenges in sales for salespeople? How to deal with negativity from the client?
那对销售人员来说呢，有一个非常有最一个最大的挑战呢，就是说如何应对客户那个带来的负面情绪。I
have them think about a situation where they used their strengths and they managed to deal with the negativity from the client, with self-confidence and high self-esteem.
那么就是他们可能，而这些销售人员呢，他们可能不太会就是通过自尊，然后自可能不能很，是通过自尊还有自信的去应对，去对应对客户带来的那个消极的情绪。
I remember one day I was mentoring a salesperson, and one of his top character strengths was humor.
那有一天就是我辅导了一位，就是一位销售人员，然后他有一个最大的性格优势就是幽默。
And I asked him to tell me a story where he used humor to deal successfully with a difficult client.
那我让他给我讲一个故事，就是关于他如何利用幽默来那个应付比较麻烦的客户。
And he shared the story with me, how humor helped him with deal with a client. That's okay. That's okay. Don't worry about it. You're doing a great job. Thank you. So then I said, okay, how did this make you feel? What if every time you have a difficult case with a client, you use your humor, which is your strength, to be able to deal with negativity?
那我就问他了，你就在面对这些客户的时候，你能够利用幽默巧妙的化解。那这个时候，你是有什么样的感受？
The moment he could think of himself being so productive and efficient using humor, the more he started using his strength, performance went high up, the more that he could to deal with difficult situations.
他在他就是在这个与客户打交道的时候，他可以让他的工作就更高效、更富有成效。如果他在比较麻烦的处境下，更多的利用幽默的话，可以让他业绩大幅提升。那他也理解了，就是有利用自己的优势去跟客户建立一种关系，也是可以带来非常大的好处的。
So to summarize, as mentors, we have the opportunity to incorporate storytelling in our relationship with our mentees.
那作为一位导师呢，我们有很多机会通过讲故事，然后来增强与学员之间的关系。
Stories that we were the hero, stories that we failed, and we learned a lesson, and this is a lesson that we can share with our mentees.
那就是当我们是自己是故事中的主角时，那就在这个故事当中呢，我们遭遇了失败，然后又从失败中吸取教训，并获得成功。故事跟学员分享。
Stories we can invite our mentees from their point of view about them being the hero, dealing with struggles, and how they dealt with them successfully.
那我们可以邀请学员来分享他们自己的故事，就是他们会遇到了什么样的困难，然后又是如何处理这些困难的。
or stories we choose from our own history, from books, or from other stories that we know and we would like to share, provided, as we said before, they're relevant.
那这些故事呢，也可以是，比如说我们过去曾经，比如说在书上看到的故事，也可以是我们自己可以拿出来分享。
Doing this, we make our mentees listen to us more, with more attention because they want to hear the ending.
那通过讲这些故事呢，我们可以让学员更。故事，因为他们往往会对故事的结局感到好奇。
And also stories that our mentees understand that we are on the same level with them, and we're as human as they are. And this is what will finally bring us much closer to them and establish a long-lasting relationship of trust.
那通过这些故事呢，也可以，就是让我们学员就是产生共鸣。那作为人类呢，作为人，我们可能都会遇到这样的问题，以此拉近我们跟他们之间的距离，从而建立一个长久的信任关系。
And the final advice, make the stories short. Don't use too many useless details.
那我在这里我要给一个建议，就是你讲故的时候要尽可能的简短，就不要用那些没有用的话语。
Don't act superior with your stories. Don't make your mentees think that you are the best person that's ever been in this world. Be humble, in other words.
那讲故事的时候呢，就是不要。以一副高高在上的姿态去讲故事，要不要让好像让学员觉得你好像是这个世界上最厉害的人，你要保持一个谦虚的态度。
Also, never say, "Let me tell you a story." This is not about classroom. It's a from our own lives.
那你要讲述一个真实的故事，真实的发生在我们生。
And make sure the stories have a happy ending, they have a moral, a lesson learned, and then build on this and help your mentees set goals based on the lessons they learned from the story.
那然后故事呢，你要有一个好的结局，然后要涉及到你从这个故事当中能学到什么，然后以此呢帮助我们的学员去设定目标。
And this is it from my part. Thank you very much. And I'm happy now for questions and answers.
那以上就是我今天要讲的内容，大家有什么问题吗？欢迎提问。Here is the question.
Yep.
From my perspective, the storytelling aims to get closer with your mentee and discover their strengths, ignite potential, set goals, and reach a consensus. Am I right?
You are absolutely right. This is what I have been experiencing myself when I use the stories, because it is this emotional connection, as you said very well, that brings people closer.
就说的非常对，因为这个也是我自己亲身的经历。因为通过讲故事这种方式呢，我们可以拉近人与人之间的距离。Another question. When we tell stories, what structure we need to follow?
The story starts with a hero. The hero is you, the mentor. It could be the mentee or a story that you have chosen from a bank of stories. Then the story must have a conflict, a struggle, a solution, and finally, the main message, which is what you want your mentee to remember.
那主要由四个部分构成。那第一个部分呢是，就是故事。首先你要有一个主角，这个主角可以是导师，也可以是学员，或者从你的，比如说你的知识储备库里面，可能任意选择的一个故事里面的一个主人公。那第二个要素呢，就是关于冲突。那这个故事里面一定要有冲突，可能包括你遇到的一些困难啊、障碍之类的。第三个呢，就是解决方案，就是应对冲突的一个解决方案。那最后呢，就是主要的信息，就是你从这个故事当中你学到了什么，它让你记住了什么。And when we tell stories, humor is humor a requisite? And because in many occasions we tell stories based on different purposes, and is there an underlying framework for us to think about the problem, to think about it?
I would say it's not so much using humor or not using humor. It's more like how optimistic your story is, how you make your mentee feel nice about it and not be scared or terrified with your story.
那这个故事呢，我可能就是重点其实不在于幽默与否，更多的是你的故事里面要充满一个乐观积极的一个情绪，然后让你的学员呢就是有一个积极的心态，就不去害怕，然后在面对困难的时候就无所畏惧，要勇敢，所以更多的是强调一个乐观积极。